I'm pretty sure for the ones who remember Clarence when they were watching Steven Universe and other cartoons around the time new episodes aired, I'm pretty sure that they either remember Clarence as a show with mostly gross out humor and mostly at the fact that the characters are really designed differently that really didn't give a good impression. But the thing is, I mostly see Clarence as basically a filler cartoon in Cartoon Network, mostly at the fact that it's, even if I can respect this show being its own thing, and I can understand where people are coming from saying that this show is slightly better than Steven Universe due to the creative directions, but after watching this episode, Merry Moochmas, it really feels a little complicated for a show like this to do a better holiday episode. And the thing is, I can understand the motivation and the direction that they're taking for the episode's premise, but at the same time, this really feels mostly another episode instead of just being a Christmas episode. Clarence's wish during Christmas is to have it snow in Arizona, and all the while he tries to have Bellison and his cousin get along during this holiday. To be honest, judging by the premise of this episode, I'm pretty sure that every other episode, regardless if it's holidays related or not, it's always gonna be like this. Mostly everyday situations and trying to have a perfect ending for one of the characters. But at the same time, that's basically what people enjoy from this show, is the fact that it's not like Steven Universe, well, it has an important narrative to follow. It's mostly a slice of life series. And this was a year before We Bare Bears aired on Cartoon Network. And just looking at the facial designs of Bellison and Gary Mooch, which are mostly similar to one of the characters from regular show and Nom Nom from We Bare Bears, I assume that the future shows took inspiration from this, but they turned them into much more better successful shows than this. Here's the thing about this episode. I can't say that it isn't a Christmas episode because it's taking place during Christmas, but at the same time, it doesn't really feel like it has anything interesting to do involving the holiday. Now, we all know that Clarence wants to have snow in Arizona, but at the same time, he also wants Bellison and Gary Mooch to get along during this holiday. I can tell that Clarence is optimistic like Laszlo from Camp Laszlo, but at the same time, he's mostly like Steven, except that he's much more chubbier and not much of a crystal gem because he isn't part gem. But at the same time, I don't consider him annoying whatsoever because he's a child still. But considering that Clarence's friends, who are mostly the highlight of the show, don't appear whatsoever during this episode, it really makes Clarence's appearance as a solo character a little bit more shallow to enjoy. Now look, I am fully aware that there are still a few episodes that centers around Clarence when it comes to him being a solo character. But the thing is, the majority of this episode being mostly Bellison not getting along with his cousin, not to mention that his cousin opened one of his Christmas gifts that he was about to open for himself, I'm pretty sure that the title Merry Moochmas was basically something that people just don't care about each other, except they do whatever they do something that people just do not like, and we're gonna get to that once we get into the ending. I can't say that Belson is a really intolerable character to sit through, considering that this is the first episode I've seen from him, and he's somewhat of a friend towards Clarence, but unfortunately, since that he's dealing with his cousin who is mostly against him because he only thinks about himself, I'm pretty sure that the family that he's in isn't really something that he really wanted. I can instantly tell that his motivations is justified in the fact that he's really depressed in the inside, that he takes out his angle, well, slight angle towards others, but in all honesty, I really feel like that the episodes I've kind of seen involving Belson in previous seasons, mainly the first, knowing full well of how many episodes each season has, I'm pretty sure that Gary Mooch would have been written a lot more differently if he wasn't in the position where he's mostly grumpy and only thinks about himself. If anything, Belson's mother just barely does anything in order to fix the situation involving Belson and Gary Mooch. If any other mother or father sees one of the cousins or sons completely opening the presents that were meant for that one sophistic person, they would instantly take matters into their own hands by giving consequences towards that someone. And considering that the mother never saw anything that happened between Belson and Gary Mooch, it really makes this entire episode difficult to follow and understand of how anything Christmas related in this really fits. Look, adding snow or having family drama into the mix doesn't mean that this should be a good episode involving Christmas. I mean, sure, you can make a Christmas episode in a different way you want, but the way I see it and the fact that this episode is 11 minutes and people actually enjoy this show more than Steven Universe, then I really feel like that this episode could have been much more differently if it had more of Clarence's friends into the mix. Because the title, Merry Moochmas, I honestly thought that that episode with a title like that would have been about people being fat and not doing much, and I can understand this being somewhat of that of Gary Mooch only thinking about himself, but at the same time, Belson doesn't really think about himself, and he's mostly friends towards Clarence, for the most part. When it comes to the ending, Clarence completely destroyed the polypus system that Belson really wanted, which leads to Belson throwing snowballs at Clarence, with Gary Mooch by his side, throwing snowballs as well. And that's when they're starting to get along at the end. It's understandable that these characters will have an ending like this when one of the characters breaks something that they ever wanted. But at the same time, with the lack of music, which I'm pretty sure it could be a problem, and the fact that Clarence is mostly oblivious on the fact that he's getting attacked by snowballs, Clarence is basically like Patrick, except that he isn't heartless. And whenever I completely look at moments involving the characters getting along, all because of an incident that one of the characters did that ends up fixing everything, it raises more questions onto why this episode got greenlit for a Christmas episode. And the ending, where Clarence sees Santa with his reindeers in the sky for about 1 or 2 seconds, it really makes me believe that the writers are getting sick of seeing so many episodes involving Santa Claus, so they make an episode without Santa Claus with Clarence just looking at Santa Claus for about 2 seconds. Sorry that my impressions are really low, especially in an episode like this, but the thing is, I've watched Wee Bear Bear's Christmas Parties as my first episode of the series, and it gave me a good impression. And I'm not expecting so much from this episode, but just seeing how these characters are being portrayed in Christmas that doesn't really feel anything else, aside from the fact that it's taking place in Christmas and it's mostly about family drama, but in the wrong way, and a character expecting snow because of his wish. I really feel like that this episode would have been better if it actually had more attention to it. But to give this episode credit, it made me interested in what this show can deliver when it comes to one of the episodes. So, I'm planning on binge watching this show, but don't expect me to review an episode sooner or later. Granted, when it comes to holiday episodes, it's a possibility, but for everything else, believe me, 2022, being the same as this year, it's going to be a busy year on reviewing so many cartoons in such a short amount of time. Whenever I think about Clarence and the fact that it's mostly the shallow cartoon compared to other popular cartoons that were airing around that time, it really sums up the Cartoon Network wants to add so many variety to those shows, but at the same time, it's difficult to make the variety work when most of the cartoons aren't really that memorable when it comes to other cartoons overshadowing that cartoon. To be perfectly honest, that's what I think about Clarence once I watch this episode and the direction it's taking. Granted, you can say that there are so much ways for Clarence to succeed for its own creativity, but for me personally, this episode really feels a lot more less than a Christmas episode. I'm giving this episode a 6 out of 10.